Sridhar Mani profile, Dr. Mani has born in 15 January 1953. He has completed his MBBS in Stanley Medical College in 1978. And his clinical experience is worked in the Department of Radiotherapy, Cancer Institute, Adair Stanley, in 1978. Worked as a medical officer in the new resident welfare address from 1979 to 82. Looking after 24 50 organs clubs. And worked as a part-time medical officer at Rotary Nagar from 1982 to 1992. In the Rotary Nagar slum and the Rotary Club of Better. Working as junior specialist in Department of Psychiatry at Voluntary Health Service and Public Health Center responsible since 1983. He is in charge of Rajaji Radiation Center at VHS. He worked as an assistant to Dr. S. Vijay Kumar and Dr. Lakshmi Vijay Kumar. Both are consultant psychiatrists from 1983 to 2011. He has established a private practice in Ashok Nagar and regularly gives lectures in nearby schools. Conducts workshops along with the clinical psychologist on topics like stress management, communication skills, interpersonal relationships, and team building for hospital staff. He is currently working on forming an association for bipolar mood disorders. So there are other activities in the pipeline. There are psychoeducation on bipolar mood disorder in Tamil and computer and mental health in Tamil. Now I request Dr. Mani to deliver the lecture.
Hello. We welcome Dr. Mani for the lecture. But we are all doctors. I can have 1 minute talk. Most of us are physicians and surgeons. We treat body. Treating mind is something great. Mind, where it is, we do not know. Like art. Like not the physical art. So, we welcome and elaborate alcoholism, which is a burning problem today, especially in the younger population. Thank you.
At the outset, I thank the IMA Kodambakkam branch, CME coordinator Dr. Chandrasekhar, Dr. Arunachalam secretary, Dr. S. Subramaniam joint secretary, for giving me an opportunity to talk on the subject alcoholism today's scenario. On behalf of Dr. V. Raju, with whom I work for more than 29 years. Even though Raju is known to me as a family physician, he has treated many of our family members. Dr. Kanagavalli's wife, many of the children were born in our nursing home in Janamma Nursing Home in Aryapuram. Dr. Raju is a living legend. Unfortunately, he couldn't make on his health grounds. And he always treated me as a family member. And I had all the privileges in the nursing home. And he's always open to any constructive criticism. Today, 43 South Usman Road, Raju Hospital is a landmark. Amidst Pothis, amidst Nathalla Jewelleries, and so on and so forth. With this brief introduction, I was given 18 minutes to talk about alcoholism today's scenario. It's impossible. Anyway, I'll try to do justice. This is the pharmacology where I read by Ishwar Iyer. If you want to drink, drink. Drink as much as you can, but drink what the fish drinks. Next slide, please. Next slide. Now I'm going to talk on this agenda. First, is it a disease? Is it curable? Role of drugs, role of psychotherapy and family therapy, role of AA meetings, role of primary care physicians, role of policy makers. Next. I always tell my patient it is a disease. It is classified under the Diagnostic Statistics Manual of Mental Health. It has come in the fifth edition, it comes under substance abuse disorder. I always give an analogy, it is like diabetes, it is chronic, with remission and relapse. Once an alcoholic, always an alcoholic. Next slide. Is it curable? No, it is not curable. It is controllable. Next case. Role of drugs. There are a number of drugs which has come into the market, but the time tested is disulfiram. The usual dose is 500 milligrams, but unfortunately our Indian population do not tolerate the 500 milligrams. Disulfiram is not a user-friendly drug. It's got a lot of side effects, right from psychosis, dermatological complications, impotence, and so on and so forth. I remember one of my patients, my name is Murugan, working in High Court. I treated him for a chronic alcoholism because he was a very aggressive fellow and a kung fu fighter. He used to be very physically abusive. I admitted him in public health center. I put him on disulfiram, and he later on he stopped drinking. But he started spreading the message in Metropolis. Never go to Dr. Mani, he'll make you impotent. If you go to alcohol, take it. So it's not a useful. Another drug which has come into the market recently, Comperol, 333 milligrams, 2 TDS. The cost of the drug will come to 72 rupees. I always tell, in my personal experience, it's a glorified placebo. It is claimed as an anti-craving drug. It is not so. The next is Naltrexone, which is a very specific drug used in opium dependence. But now, they have started using in alcohol. Again, a very costly drug, 50 rupees per day. For that, you go and buy a quarter bottle of whiskey. Topiramate is also another drug which is used for alcoholism. Next slide. The role of psychotherapy and family therapy. It is the key in the treatment of alcoholism. It produces good results provided the individual and the family participate. I have my own personal experience because my eldest brother, who has made me a doctor, he himself is an alcoholic. In the past 40 years, we are going through a roller coaster phenomenon. I know in and about out of alcoholism, only for the past 2 years, he is sober. It drains you, emotionally drains you, as a family member, as a wife, and so on and so forth. But I always tell, alcoholics are diseased people, but they are not bad. That's how you have to counsel the patient. Otherwise, there is a rejection, and the patients will leave you by divorce. Next. This is what we do in the Rajaji Addiction Center in VHS also. Now, AA meetings. These are all meetings conducted all over the city. If you see the newspaper, AA meetings. Alcoholic Anonymous. These are recovered alcohols. They meet once in a week and share their experiences, how to come out of this problem, how they came out. Now, after coming out, how they are insulted by the society. Because once you are an alcoholic, your wife always, or your relatives always, hit you that you did on so and so and such and such a day, recall the past, hurt him, and only once push him back to alcohol. So these alcoholic anonymous, these people share their grievances, their coping skills are shared so that they remain sober. Al-Anon is for the family members, especially the wives of alcoholics. We have meetings for children of alcoholics also because it affects the children very badly. Next please. The role of primary care physician is very, very important. You can initiate treatment. Many of them feel that alcoholism cannot be treated by primary care physician. Today I want to reassure you, you can boldly treat by starting an IV fluid. If he or she taking alcohol for a long time, 1 week IV fluid with the injection bifenthrin, which is a very safe drug. Thiamine was available, but it's a very dangerous drug and they have withdrawn from the market because of the cost factor, and thiamine is also very good for withdrawal symptoms. Now manage the withdrawal symptoms at your clinic. If you have got a lot of other problems like comorbid illness, alcoholism per se is not one disease. Always this underlying bipolar mood disorder will be there. It may be a schizophrenia, or it may be a depression, or it may be a personality disorder. So that has to be addressed. That needs a specialist reference. So first week you can detoxify him. Look, Dr. Mani, I have detoxified in the clinic. You can take over. He has got other issues. So the crisis intervention, if it is done, it's easy to manage. It will also reduce the morbidity and mortality. Next step. With a lot of policymakers. Here comes Dr. Arunachalam's role. He's a very dynamic leader. He's fighting for and contesting for election also. And the IMA Kodambakkam branch is strongly recommending him to be the one of the candidates for Tamil Nadu Medical Council. Punjab stands first, followed by Andhra Pradesh, and then Tamil Nadu in India when it comes to consumption of alcohol. Now, about 2 weeks back, I read in Ananda Vigran, 18,000 crores is the revenue generated by Tasmak shops, out of which 1 crore has been allotted for treatment of alcohol-related disease, which is shame. When the present Chief Minister, Honorable Chief Minister Jayalalitha won around May 11th, and the next day, with the help of my wife, I sent her an email congratulating her for landslide victory. I said, in all over the world, 25% of the income generated from the industry of alcohol is used for psychoeducation and also prevention of alcohol-related disease. Kindly do something to the Tamil Nadu government. We are having grants from the state, the central government, social justice and empowerment, if the policy sum of 6 lakhs for 1 year, for that, you have to run around for 3 years. 2003 grant will come in 2006. The desk officer doesn't work over the desk, he works under the desk. It's a plain fact. I said, being in charge of the medical officer, we will not give. VHS is a voluntary organization, cannot afford to give any cover under the desk. Let us see the records. You come for inspection, they come for inspection. And then the state government comes for inspection. They are certified, I'm proud to say, VHS is the best record. But still the grant will not come. So that is the problem. 1 crore, 18,000 crore is the income. The government is run on the income of Tasmak shop. Next, please. So take all messages. There is no need to press the bell. I finish it before that. Alcoholism is a growing menace among men and women. More and more young people are addicted to alcohol, as rightly said by our co-chairperson. The youngest alcoholic I have seen is 12. And recently in one of the premier institutions in KK Nagar Central Board School, one boy brought a water bottle mixed with whiskey. He was studying in 8th standard. Because his father is an alcoholic. Please, ladies and gentlemen, don't treat alcohol. It's a very, very simple disease. Road traffic accident and drunken driving are on the rise. Once ETR road came, VHS has become very popular for road traffic accident. The Ramamurthy's neurosurgical ward is full of only alcoholic people with subdural hematoma. From you name it, all problems are there. Multiple fractures, everything. Heart compression, paraplegia, everything. Only drunken driver by the IT people. All youngsters. Physical and sexual abuse, I would like to narrate 2 cases. Sexual abuse, you cannot imagine. One patient was admitted in Rajaji De-Addiction Center from Tirthali. He used to insert a hot iron into the vagina of his wife. Can you ever imagine? Under the influence of alcohol. Another gentleman used to drink throughout the night, asking her wife to be stripped naked. He has to stand in front of her till he finishes from 6 o'clock till the day. Another person used to have sex except with his mother. Incest, with all his sister, used to go on have sex by almost amounting to rape. Alcoholism is one of the commonest causes for suicide. Broken homes, divorces, and dropouts on educational institutions are sequel of alcoholism. Crime rates are increasing. SRK, our famous celebrity Shah Rukh Khan, the holder of Kolkata Knight Riders, under the influence of alcohol, slashed a security guard openly in Wankhede Stadium, and the Wankhede Stadium has banned him for 5 years. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I am prepared to take any questions. Even though Raju is known to me as a family physician. He has treated many of our family members. Dr. Kanagavalli, his wife, many of the children were born in our nursing home, in Janama Nursing Home in Aryapuram. Dr. Raju is a living legend. Unfortunately, he couldn't make on his health grounds. And he always treated me as a family member. And I had all the privileges in the nursing home. And he's always open to any constructive criticism. And today, 43 South Usman Road, Raju Hospital, is a landmark. Amidst Pothis, amidst Nathalla Jewelleries, and so on and so forth. With this brief introduction, I was given 18 minutes to talk about alcoholism today's scenario. It's impossible. Anyhow, I'll try to do justice. This is the pharmacology where I read by Ishwar Iyer. If you want to drink, drink. Drink as much as you can, but drink what the fish drinks. Next slide, please. Now I am going to talk on this agenda. First is it a disease? Is it curable? Role of drugs, role of psychotherapy and family therapy, role of AA meetings, role of primary care physicians, role of policy makers. Next. I always tell my patient it is a disease. It is classified under the Diagnostic Statistics Manual of Mental Health. It has come in the fifth edition, it comes under substance abuse disorder. I always give an analogy, it is like diabetes, it is chronic, with remission and relapse. Once an alcoholic, always an alcoholic. Next slide. Is it curable? No, it is not curable, it is controllable. Next slide. Role of drugs. There are a number of drugs which have come into the market, but the time tested is disulfiram. The usual dose is 500 milligrams, but unfortunately our Indian population do not tolerate the 500 milligrams. Disulfiram is not a user-friendly drug. It's got a lot of side effects, right from psychosis, dermatological complications, impotence, and so on and so forth. I remember one of my patients, my name is Murugan, working in the High Court. I treated him for a chronic alcoholism because he was a very aggressive fellow and a kung fu fighter. He used to be very physically abusive. Admitted in public health center, I put him on disulfiram and he later on, he stopped drinking. But he started spreading the message in Metropolis, never go to Dr. Mani, he'll make you impotent. If you go to alcohol, take it. So it's not a useful thing. Another other drug which has come into the market recently, Comprol, 333 milligram, 2 TDS. The cost of the drug will come to 72 rupees. I always tell, in my personal experience, it's a glorified placebo. It is claimed as an anti-craving drug. It is not so. The next is naltrexone, which is a very specific drug used in opium dependence. But now, they have started using in alcohol. Again, a very costly drug, 50 rupees per day. For that, you go and buy a quarter bottle of whiskey. Topiramate is also another drug which is used for alcoholism. Next slide. The role of psychotherapy and family therapy. It is the key in the treatment of alcoholism. It produces good results provided the individual and the family participate. I have my own personal experience because my eldest brother, who has made me a doctor, he himself is an alcoholic. In the past 40 years, we are going through a roller coaster phenomenon. I know in and out of alcoholism, only for the past 2 years, he's sober. It drains you, emotionally drains you, as a family member, as a wife, and so on and so forth. But I always tell, alcoholics are diseased people, but they are not bad. That's how you have to counsel the patient. Otherwise, there is a rejection, and the patients will leave you by divorce. Next. This is what we do in the Rajaji Addiction Center in VHS also. Now, AA meetings. These are all meetings conducted all over the city. If you see the newspaper, AA meetings. Alcoholic Anonymous. These are recovered alcohols. They meet once in a week and share their experiences, how to come out of this problem, how they came out. after coming out, how they are insulted by the society. Because once you are an alcoholic, your wife always or your relatives always hit you that you did on so and so and such and such a day, recall the past, hurt him and only once push him back to alcohol. So these alcoholic anonymous, these people share their grievances, their coping skills are shared so that they remain sober. Al-Anon is for the family members, especially the wives of alcoholics. We have meetings for children of alcoholics also, because it affects the children very badly. Next, please. The role of primary care physician is very, very important. You can initiate treatment. Many of them feel that alcoholism cannot be treated by primary care physician. Today, I want to reassure you, you can boldly treat by starting an IV fluid if he or she taking alcohol for a long time. 1 week IV fluid with the injection with Neurin, which is a very safe drug. Thiamine was available, but it's a very dangerous drug and they have withdrawn from the market because of the cost factor, and thiamine is also very good for withdrawal symptoms. Now, manage the withdrawal symptoms at your clinic. We have got a lot of other problems like comorbid illness. Alcoholism per se is not one disease. Always this underlying bipolar mood disorder will be there. It may be a schizophrenia, or it may be a depression, or it may be a personality disorder. So that has to be addressed. That needs a specialist reference. So first week you can detoxify him. Look, Dr. Mani, I have detoxified in the clinic. You can take over. He has got other issues. So the crisis intervention, if it is done, it's easy to manage. It will also reduce the morbidity and mortality. Next step. The role of policy makers. Here comes Dr. Arunachalam's role. He's a very dynamic leader. He's fighting for and contesting for election also. And the IMA Kodambakkam branch is strongly recommending him to be the one of the candidates for Tamil Nadu Medical Council. Punjab stands first, followed by Andhra Pradesh, and then Tamil Nadu in India when it comes to consumption of alcohol. Now, about 2 weeks back, I read in Ananda Vigran, 18,000 crores is the revenue generated by Tasmak shops, out of which 1 crore has been allotted for treatment of alcohol-related disease, which is shame. When the present Chief Minister, Honorable Chief Minister Jayalalitha, won around May 11th, and the next day, with the help of my wife, I sent her an email congratulating her for landslide victory. I said, in all over the world, 25% of the income generated from the industry of alcohol is used for psychoeducation and also prevention of alcohol-related disease. Kindly do something to the Tamil Nadu government. We are having grants from the state.
Hello. Next, we are honoring Dr. Sarvathri.
Sir, garland.
எலெக்ஷன் கிட்டக்க வர வர பதட்டம் ஜாஸ்தியா இருக்கு.
I am very happy that the IMA Kodambakkam branch is honored in front of my teacher, who is going to be honored next.